In the year 1999, high above Macross Island in the South Pacific, a phenomenal event occurred in the skies which altered the course of human history. A gigantic alien spaceship broke through the very fabric of hyperspace on a collision course with the Earth. During its uncontrolled fall from the sky, the plummeting space fortress produced shockwaves of incredible force. Measured nearly 3/4 of a mile in length, there was no sign of the alien crew. The armored hull had taken the brunt of the damage, leaving much of the sophisticated technosystems intact. What remained of the giant battle fortress gave evidence of a civilization that was light years ahead of Earth's most advanced thinking. Global war ravaged the Earth at that time, but even this devastation paled by comparison to the threat of invasion from outer space. A ceasefire was ordered, and world leaders banded together to form a united Earth government. Under the new government, the world's most brilliant minds formed a research team to study and restore the alien space fortress. Deciphering parts of documents found on board, they labored to unravel the secrets of an incredibly complex technology called Robotech. Convinced that the scientists had solved this complex riddle, world leaders ordered a celebration. For 10 years, the total resources of an entire planet had been focused on the restoration of the space fortress. A great city had grown up around the Robotech project, and today, on the eve of the ship's maiden flight, every citizen, man, woman, and child, was gathering to celebrate their achievement and to witness the launching of their planet's new defender.
It's the big shots making their grand entrance.
Captain Glovell doesn't seem too happy about it.
Don't look so sour, Captain Glovell. It's our big day. Surely you realize all those loyal citizens out there consider you their hero. I think you could at least wave to them.
All right, I'll wave.
The countdown has begun. On board the giant spaceship, the crew of raw recruits, freshly graduated from the Robotech Academy, is busy with the pre-launch checklist.
Green light.
The ceremony starts in 15 minutes. I hope the captain gets here in time. I hear he didn't get much sleep last night.
Yeah, the other officers threw a farewell party for him. They probably sat up all night telling each other war stories. You know how they are.
And where were you, Claudia?
What are you talking about, Lisa?
You didn't come in until 4 this morning. You must have been partying, too.
You jealous? I had a late dinner with Commander Foker.
Claudia!
What?
You stayed out all night knowing you both had flight duty today.
So, what's the big fuss about, Lisa? We won't let it affect the performance of our duty. After all, we're not children and you're not our mother.
Your responsibilities to the ship come first, Claudia.
But my private life is my business, nobody else's. Now then, let's get to work, all right? Get out of here.
Lisa doesn't understand about men, Claudia. She's in love with this spaceship.
Yeah, you got that right.
Oh, don't argue.
I'm not the one who keeps butting into everybody's business.
I'm warning you.
I hate to interrupt, but hadn't you better check your monitor, Commander?
It's an unidentified incoming aircraft, Lisa.
Attention aircraft approaching on course 107.
Please identify yourself. Please identify yourself.
This is Rick Hunter, invitation number 201.
That's confirmed as an invitation from Lieutenant Commander Foker. Follow course 57 for landing.
Roger.
Now we present a display of aerial acrobatics demonstrating the amazing advances we have made through robo-technology. Lieutenant Commander Roy Poker, leader of the Veritech Fighter Squadron, will describe the action for us.
Today, you'll see how we've applied human know-how to a complex alien technology. Keep your eyes on planes 2 and 4. Flying at speeds of 800 miles per hour, only 50 feet above the ground, they will pass within just a few yards of one another. Robotechnology makes such precision possible.
Huh?
Oh, no! Rick! Is that you, Rick Hunter?
Roy! It's good to hear your voice, old buddy. I understand you're a lieutenant commander now.
Are you crazy? Get that junk heap out of here! Hunter, when I get my hands on you, I'm gonna...
Hey, Ed, switch this to radio only, will ya? What are you trying to do, buddy? Make a perfect fool of me?
Nobody's perfect, Commander.
You haven't changed a bit, have you? Well, this isn't your dad's amateur flying circus.
My men are real pilots.
I'm gonna have to make you eat those words, Commander. Coming in.
Think you are? What were you trying to do? Get yourself killed?
Hey, calm down.
And while we're at it, where'd you learn to do that anyway?
It was just a simple booster climb. You taught me that yourself when I was just a kid. Hey, I have to admit those guys are pretty good. Not as good as me, of course.
You don't have to brag to me, Rick. I know all about your winning the amateur flying competition last year.
Actually, I've won it 8 years in a row. What have you been doing?
I was busy fighting a war. I guess you didn't read about my having shot down 108 enemy planes.
You're proud of being a killer?
What? There was a war on and I was a soldier. I just did my duty.
You promised my dad that as soon as the war was over, you'd come back to the air circus. Why did you go back on that promise, Roy?
I really felt guilty about letting your father down. Only, this Robotech thing is so exciting, I just couldn't give it up. It just gets in your blood or something, I don't know.
What is Robotech, anyway? Just more modern war machinery. And the aliens, huh?
J-Bomb and J-Bomb and J-Bomb, you
two
man, I've already had fun. You can't have any more.
No, Jason. Cancel the order, please. Oh, you'll get sick.
I don't care.
That's it. We're going home.
Huh? Well, Roy, I see you're still a big ladies' man.
Blasting through a warp fold in deep space, a gigantic alien spaceship enters Earth's solar system in pursuit of the damaged Robotech vessel, which has eluded capture by slipping through the time-space continuum. The command ship leads a vast armada of battle vessels manned by the Zentraedi, a race of warriors bred for thousands of generations for the sole purpose of military conquest.
The finder beam has locked on this planet. Are you sure this is where the transmission was coming from?
Yes, sir. I'm puzzled.
They could have executed a refold.
It's doubtful, sir. There was no evidence of a second drop into hyperspace.
They couldn't have gone far in their condition. They would have to have landed in order to repair the ship. That's a logical speculation, I think.
I agree. It would seem very likely, sir.
Send a scout team.
Wow. This fighter's a real beauty, all right. It looks great, but how does it handle?
Well, why don't you just climb aboard and see for yourself?
You mean that?
Sure. I'll go along and ride piggyback behind you. The controls may look pretty complicated, but I'll check you out on them.
I'm not worried. If you can learn to fly one of these things, I can.
Don't be so modest.
This is a day that we've all been looking forward to for 10 years. The Robotech project has been a tremendous asset to the economy of Macross City.
Excuse me, sir. Urgent message from the space monitoring station. A strange flash of light and an explosion followed by irregularities in the gravitational field.
The same sort of thing happened 10 years ago. You know what happened then, don't you?
That's when the alien ship arrived.
Better check it out.
Every system aboard the ship is starting up. The defense system is activating the main guns to fire. Shut down all systems. It doesn't work. Captain, the main guns are preparing to fire. I can't control them. What do we do?
Look at that! Now we know for sure that the ship is on that planet. All ships continue advancing, but exercise extreme caution.
We have control now. What happened, sir?
What were all those fireworks about?
I don't know. I better go check. Wait here. I'll see what's going on.
The space monitor report is coming in. It shows what our guns were firing at.
I have it here, Sammy. Two large objects, probably spaceships, in lunar orbit 200,000 miles out. Both objects were struck dead center by the beam and were disintegrated. Huh?
Huh? Captain, what is it? What are you laughing about?
It was so obvious! We should have known! A booby trap, of course!
Booby trap, sir?
Yes, it's one of the oldest tricks in military history. A retreating enemy leaves behind hidden explosives and such. The aliens who abandoned the ship armed it with an automatic defense system designed to detect and destroy their enemies.
The activation of the guns means that unfriendly forces have approached close enough to be a threat to us.
Captain Glover!
Yes, what is it, Sammy?
No smoking on the bridge! Huh? It's against regulations, sir.
I was just holding it. I wasn't going to light it.
Scramble all the fighters and prepare for combat!
Enemy forces approaching in sector 412.
Yes. But why are they using such primitive weapons? Our scout ships have broken through! It's unbelievable. Some sort of trick, no doubt.
Yes, it is, Puzzle.
It makes no sense.
There has to be a reason, but it's beyond me. Surely the Robotech Masters...
Commander Breton, the two enemy space cruisers are approaching. They may be the ones who launched the missile bombardment.
Blast them to bits. Those idiots behave as though they don't even know how to use their own weapons! Full barrage, all cannons!
This is Armor 10 Space Cruiser calling SDF-1! Come in, SDF-1!
Armor 10 is heavily damaged, sir.
I had hoped this moment wouldn't come in my lifetime. After we finally achieved peace on our planet, now we face annihilation by alien forces whose power is beyond our imagination. I had hoped that war was a thing of the past. But here we go again. All right, move out!
Yes, sir. All forces, move out!
We are under attack by alien invaders from Sector 412. This is not a drill. Repeat, this is not a drill. All forces proceed at once in battle formation.
Well, boys, you heard her. This is the real thing.
Wolf team has cleared. Skull team, prepare for takeoff.
Skull team ready. All right, men, this is it. Let's go!
What a disorderly arrangement. These people are completely ignorant of space war tactics. What? That's Zor's battle fortress, but what's happened to it?
It appears to have been completely remodeled. Perhaps by the inhabitants of that planet.
Mere Micronians couldn't possibly have captured a Robotech ship.
Maybe it crashed on their planet and they managed to salvage it.
What about the crew? They wouldn't just let them have it.
Maybe they were killed in the crash.
Even so, the ship would have been seriously damaged and these primitives wouldn't have the technology to repair it.
I know, sir. But is there any other explanation? It is a Robotech vessel. We know they have...
reflex weaponry.
Precisely, and this makes them very dangerous, so we must exercise caution.
Target pinpointed, Commander. We're launching fighters.
It's not that much different from the good old days with the flying circus.
Yeah, but I never got shot at the circus, Roy.
You'll get used to it. Just tag along behind me for a while, if you can keep up with me.
If I can, I'll do my best not to leave you behind.
That's the spirit. Let's go get him, little brother.
Oh,
ground control calling VF-102. Pull out! You're diving right at us!
Tell me something I don't know! I can't pull out! All the controls have lost their power!
Have you tried switching to configuration B?
B? What's that mean?
You don't know?
Impossible! All right, listen. Pull down the control mark B on the left side of your console.
Okay, I found it. What's it doing?
Episode of Robot Aliens Strike in Full Force, and the desperate battle for the planet Earth reaches the very streets of Macross City. Human courage and skill are tested to the limit against the superior weapons of the Zentraedi. And rescue attempt turns into a nightmare experience. Don't miss the incredible action and suspense of Countdown, the next thrilling chapter in the saga of Robotech.